الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، نعمة المهدى ورحمة المزان والاه. أعوذ بالله من شرور الأنفس ومن سيئات الأعمال، من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. الله سبحانه وتعالى make our gathering only for his sake and accept our present here today. The issue of today is the purification, internal and external purification, tahara. The last week class, I want to just to see what did we do so far. Did you follow up on the homework? Did we read more about the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Did you try to leave a day with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam from the morning to sunset? Did we say the dua in the morning? Did we remember Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam all of this week? Was NBA season or is not? It's off season, yeah. Is it the season? Okay. Then I hope those players have not occupied our heart and mind more than Rasulullah Sallam this week. I would like very much, whatever we say here, we'd like to see the change, the impact in the family life, individuals. The whole purpose of this, for myself really, to see if I can get improved by even going through this, preparing for a class. And since I say to other people, I should do it myself and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have everyone else to improve by the end of this series, that we feel that we have life have changed for the better, and we feel the improvement in our behaviors, in our attitudes, and we feel iman-wise that our iman have been increased. That's the whole purpose. And if we ask ourselves what we want to accomplish as individual in this life, each one of us have a list of things. We want to finish school, you want to have a job, you want to perhaps buy a house, and perhaps maybe get a raise, perhaps this and that. We very much in the worldly life planning, we're very good at that. We can write things, desires, and we can call objectives that we want to accomplish. And then we measure our success or failure of how much of this we accomplish. Maybe all of the things that I mentioned are noble cause. Good things. It's not prohibited to have a higher education. It's encouraged in Islam to pursue knowledge. It is not prohibited in Islam to ask for a raise in your job. It is not prohibited in Islam to own your home, if you do it, of course, according to Islamic teaching. And it's not prohibited to do certain things. It's not prohibited. But there's a himma of dunya, meaning that the person have this drive for dunya and this drive for akhirah. When the drive over dunya become more than the drive of akhirah, and actually overshadowed the whole thing, a person lose big time. Therefore, we would like very much in this class, inshallah, in this series of classes, to measure progress, you know, and to see the, inshallah, the curve going up. Rasulullah said, "Al-iman yazidu wa yanqus." Iman goes up and down, but that's minimum. You know, your car has indicator for how much gas you have. Sometimes, you know, if the light is on, you know how many miles you're going to drive before you run out of gas. Therefore, you like to avoid being even in that point so that it does not also affect the well-being of the car itself, because all the dust and the dirt come into the system. The same thing with iman. We know sometimes when it's really going down and we feel like almost only have gas. Therefore, we need to refill this. And by do this checking every time in our life and measuring and see the source that we've been mentioned where we can recharge this battery and make sure that we have enough energy to go in life, inshallah, we'll sustain our iman. Regarding purification, tahara, This is one of the most important elements in Islam. And purification or tahara has two elements. One of them, the tahara of al-batin and al-tahara of al-zahir, purification, the internal purification and external purification. What do we mean by internal purification? Anyone? The tahara of the heart, of inside. And this is one of the most important tahara purification. And by the way, today, inshallah, the notes, Sister Fatima, that we, inshallah, we will write them and we send it to you. But I want you to take notes today, do it manually, until we give you something in writing, inshallah. Therefore, we would like, before I'm going to talk about the significance and the inner dimension of the tahara of al-zahir, we want to talk about the tahara of al-batin, tahara of internal tahara, purification. And that's what the religion begins. Islam starts with the purification of the heart. What are the issues of the heart? The whole idea of Iman, that this heart is a receiving planet, a reflection mirror of the Quran, the teaching of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, come to the heart. There are certain things that cover the heart. Rejecting the truth, for example. Not accepting it. It's called kufr. And kufr create what they call it cover, just like in English. Kufr and cover, to cover. And create ghishawa, as Quran al-Kareem says. And create this sealing of the heart. In order for the heart to receive the guidance and the light, it has to clean or be clean or the veil to be removed. And Quran al-Kareem called it veil riches. Okay? And Quran al-Kareem called it ran. رَانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ وَقَالُوا قُلُوبُنَا غُلْفٌ. They say our hearts are sealed. The disbeliever, they ask him, why don't you believe? Say, because our hearts are sealed, locked. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't make that excuse. Why they were sealed? Because you made kufr, you reject the truth. وَقَالُوا قُلُوبُنَا غُلْفٌ قُلْ بَلْ طَبَعَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهَا بِكُفْرِهِمْ. Say, Allah have concealed their heart because they become kafir. They rejected the truth. And that's why ulama said, there's no person whom Allah sealed their heart not to believe. People seal their own hearts. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying here that the sealing of the heart is a result of the kufr, not the cause of it. After they become kafir, then the heart was sealed. In order for the heart to be purified, to be receiving and to be glowing and bright star, that heart to be shine has to be clean. Imam Ghazali says, this is the example of the Mishkat. And Ibn al-Qayyim also said, the Mishkat that Allah says, Allahu nuru samawati wal ard, mathalu nurihi ka mishkatin fiha misbah, al-misbah fi zujaja. Said this Mishkat, Quran gives a beautiful description in Surah An-Nur for this, the purification of the heart. He says, like a lighting and bright star and a lamb. You know, when you take a pure lamb, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing this lamb. He says, it has a pure glass. And said, the glass itself, like a bright star. And the oil from which this lamb was lighted, the oil itself is lighting without even lighting it up by itself. There's a light, glory coming from it. مِشْكَاتٍ فِيهَا مِصْبَاحٌ المِصْبَاحُ فِي زُجَاجَةٍ الزُجَاجَةُ كَأَنَّهَا كَوْكَبٌ دُرِّيٌّ يُوقَدُ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ. Imam al-Qayyim says, مَثَلَ نُورِهِ كَفِي قَلْبِ الْمُؤْمِنِ. This example of this belief is just like this light, like in the belief in the heart of the believer. Therefore, when a mu'min, his heart is pure. يَنْظُرُ بِنُورِ اللَّهِ. He sees things in the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah gave him the light. You know, Imam al-Khalifa Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, he was sick. A man came to visit him. But this man, before he stopped by Uthman home radiallahu anhu to visit, he saw a woman in the street and he didn't lower his gaze. He started staring at her and so forth. And he came to see Umar, Uthman. Then Uthman ibn Affan looked at him and said, "Idkhulu alayya ahadukum wa fi aynihi zina." Someone won't enter my room and the zina is in his eyes. The man says, "Subhanallah. Awahyum ba'da Rasulillah? Is this a revelation after the Prophet Muhammad? What's going on here?" Uthman ibn Affan said, "No, no revelation, no claim of that. Walakinaha farasatul mu'min." It is this farasa, meaning the energy and the insight Allah gives to the believer by reflecting and seeing things. He said, "Innaha farasat al-mu'min, innahu yanzuru bi nurillah." Rasulullah said, "Ittaqi farasat al-mu'min, fa innahu yanzuru bi nurillah." This mu'min, the believers, when he look at things, he see more than the surface. Therefore, the purification of the heart, it is one of the most important elements. Before you begin with the tahara of the badan, I'm going to show you the connection between them. There's a connection between the tahara of the badan, of the body, and the tahara of the heart. The heart, the tahara of the clothes, and the tahara of the heart. Therefore, it begins with this tahara of the heart. And the one of the things that create this disease in the heart, and dirt, we can call it, and Rasulullah ﷺ called it rust. Very nice description. By the way, if the heart is a mirror, if the heart is this a shiny, I can say glass, or something that reflects light, the light of the Quran, the light of the teaching of Rasulullah ﷺ, because Rasulullah ﷺ himself, Allah said him as a light, as Nur. Siraj Munir. How does Siraj Munir, the star, you know, which is like the sun? By the way, Rasulullah ﷺ, Allah said about him, because himself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. You truly guide people to the straight path. Therefore, you have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, نور السماوات والأرض. Quran is نور. جاءكم من الله نور وكتاب مبين. Quran is نور. And the Prophet is نور, is Siraj Munir, is a lighting star. See how many نورs? All of this light, the heart has to be like the moon, the planet. Like Qamar. And the Qamar, the moon, it reflect, supposed to reflect the light. Is the moon itself shining? Is anything coming, energy coming from the moon itself? Is a reflection of the sun. The heart of all the believers like the moon. And what is the sun? Is the light that comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, teaching of Allah through the Quran and the teaching of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the heart reflect the light, receive the light. And then you see the light in the face, the light in the behavior, the light in the attitude, the light in the talking, the light in everywhere. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ كَمَنْ مَثَلَهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِنْهَا. Beautiful, reflect on this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, is it equal a person who's dead and then who brought him to life? This here talking about spiritual death. Was dead, brought him to life. How? Was iman. Because iman bring life. The heart was though iman is dead. There's no life on it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا كَمَثَلَهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِنْهَا وَنَجْعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. Then that person who was dead and brought him to life, and we give him the light, a light. جَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. He walk among people with it. What that nur is? Do you know? It's the nur of iman. And what's the nur come from? From the heart. And the heart is receiving it, taking its light from this Siraj Munir, bright star. Whom that Siraj Munir? The one we talked about him last week. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And what other light? Quran. Kitab, nur wa kitab mubin. we send you a light. جاءكم نور. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this Quran is nur, light. Okay. That's what we need to reflect on. And when by the purifying our heart, then we'll be capable of receiving this light. And then we can share this light with people. We can walk with this light among people. نورا يمشي به في الناس. What are the things that will cause this bright star and pure lamp to get dirty? What are the things come to it? First is the disease of the heart. That we're going to talk about each one of them, inshallah, in this series. Shirk. Associating someone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a person does not submit completely to Allah, and this heart occupied with other things, the love of others, and created equal partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the heart will not be able to receive the light. Hiqd, grudge. A person sleep and grudge, woke up in grudge. Anna lahu nur. How can he have light? Because the heart is not clean. Hasad, envy. Riya, showing off. The heart is occupied by the looking up to people. How we're going to show off today. Ghafla, complete, did not become mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also committing sins. Imagine that the sin is a cause of reducing the amount of light. Every time that person commits sin, some of his light, you know, it goes down. Have you seen those lamp that where you can adjust them? You can, you know, have it high and then very bright and then you lower it a little bit until it becomes low. When it's bright, that is the heart in the peak of Iman. Then committing sin, a little bit down. More sin, a little bit down. More sin, a little bit down until complete is off. That's what it is. Therefore, every time we commit a sin and we don't repent, we don't go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we don't ask for forgiveness, as I'm going to say, I'm going to show you how we can keep the energy and recharge the battery, that it reduces the light. And that's why they say, for example, zina, adultery or fornication, تأخذ النور من الوجه. It takes the light from the face and make a person feel down. The energy goes down. Any kind of sins, major sin, kabair, it takes the light from the heart. And what brings then the light? How we sustain the light in the heart? How we purify our heart? Rasulullah gave us the medicine. He said, إِنَّ الْقُلُوبَ لَتَصْدَعْ. Rasulullah said, very sure the heart will be rusted. You know the rust? What do you do with something rust? You like to clean it. What do you do? Polish it. قَالَ إِنَّ الْقُلُوبَ لَتَصْدَعْ. Said the heart, where the heart will be rusted. The question came from the companions. قَالُوا وَمَا جَلَاءُهَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. How can we clean our heart, purify it? ذِكْرُ الْمَوْتِ وَتِلَاوَةِ الْقُرْآنِ. In another hadith, ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ. Remembrance of Allah, recitation of Qur'an, remembrance of death will clean it. Therefore, when you go to grocery store, you need to buy three things. Yeah. Or when you go to a pharmacy, you need to buy three things. But this pharmacy is the pharmacy of Rasulullah. Okay? He said to us, go and get the cleaning tool. He said, first, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The heart will become purified. Dhikr. Two, read the Quran, which is all the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Three, that remember death, that you will die one day. That would clean it. Also, obedience to Allah, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do more of the ta'at. Salah, for example, is one of the best ways to purify the heart. Because, as I say, there's a lot of veils come to our heart. When we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we have complete khushu', as we're going to dedicate a whole class about this, in a dimension of salah and khushu', that will purify our heart, clean our heart. The other thing is that zakah. Al-Qur'an al-Kareem say that doing charity and zakah, it brings purification. But charity here is not only money that you give. Everything that we do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purifies that heart. But look to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran. When he asked Rasul to take money from people, he said, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً. Take from their money, sadaqah, to do what? To zakihim, to tahirhum, wa to zakihim biha. So you can purify with them. We purify them with this zakah. Bring them, make them mutatahirin. Why? Because as we're going to speak about this issue of zakah or materialism, also as we talk about love of materials, that when a person gives zakah, they become what? Their heart become tender. Because you think about the poor and the needy people. That purification from what? From kibar, being arrogant, become humble. Remember the people who you need. Also from being stingy, bukhl, that purification of the heart. And also, I have a person be sharing that purification of from selfishness. Just one act, just giving zakah, giving charity, do that purification. How many diseases it cleans? Now, so far, I've said three. It could be more than that, the list. Just the act of zakah itself, when it's done with sincere heart, it does all of that things. People of sins, they need to be purified. Tahara. When we commit sin, we know that we get dirty. We need to clean the heart. From where you're getting that? Quran al-Kareem brought some people who are committing sin to witness that their sin is what? Is impurity. Allah says in Quran, when they talk about Qawm Lut, when they decide to kick them out from their city, do you know what they said? أَخْرِجُوا عَلَى لُوتٌ مِنْ قَرِيَتْكُمْ إِنَّهُمْ أُنَاسٌ what? يَتَطَهَّرُونَ. They said, kick them out of your city because they are the people who purify themselves. They steal from the sin. That was their own statement. إِنَّهُمْ أُنَاسٌ يَتَطَهَّرُونَ. Therefore, what the sin, it make a person not pure, spiritual wise. How we can clean ourselves from that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to the wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, he gave them instructions. He said, don't speak in a manner that a person have a disease in their heart. They think ill of you. He said, do not expose yourself. تَبَرَّجْنَا تَبَرُّجَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ الْأُولَى. Don't expose your body. وَأَقِمْنَا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَتِينَا الزَّكَاةَ. Establish prayer and do charity. For what purpose? All of that. إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمْ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. Allah said to the أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ, أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ, that do those things. Establish salah, prayer, stay away from sin. Because Allah wants to make you متطهرين يطهركم. Therefore, ta'a, obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bring that purification. There's a ta'a, then there's a tahara of jawarih, Imam Ghazali said. After the heart, he said this heart, it is like a generator. It produces energy to the rest of the body. He said, whatever you feed the heart, whatever the furu', the branches get. If the heart is really sick, the hand is sick. The tongue is sick. The ear is sick. The eye is sick. Every part of the body is sick. That's what Rasulullah said, أَلَا إِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةٌ very surely in the heart there's a, what an organ, in the body there's an organ. إِذَا صَلُحَ صَلُحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ. If that organ become good, the whole body become what? Good. وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ. Therefore, if you have your battery down in your car, can you have your high beam on? Can you turn on the car? Can you do anything? The car will not move. The tire could be a brand new tire. You can just get it from, you go to the price club, get new tires. And every time that you put new things, you change the new tires. You said, I think the car is not going because it was old tires. Then you said, maybe I'd like to change the lamp, although it is working. Said, no. You cannot, a person cannot be like that. If the battery is down, no matter what other things has, it will not work. The same thing with the heart, that it gets control the rest of the body. And that in the spiritual sense. And the same time, that if you have the energy, or the place where the get the energy is not there, you cannot light anything. The same things with our body. Therefore, and the jawarih can cause the battery to go down. You have a new battery. You have the light on. You turn on the car. You have the light on for 2 days, 3 days. What will happen? Okay. A person say, I have light in my heart, but he sit in 2 hours of backbiting straight. Backbiting. Straight 3 hours. You just come from Taraweeh. Then you come somebody home and on Sahur. 3 hours straight backbiting. You finish one this person, you go to another person the list. Another person the list. What happened to the light? You cried in Taraweeh. And so forth, you go 3 hours, because the tongue was the light on. It get it out. Therefore, jawarih take the light also by committing sin. With our hands, our tongue, or our eyes. You know Imam Shafi'i, the scholar. I'm going to, inshallah, stop for the, I think Maghrib, 2 minutes for Maghrib. Okay. Imam Shafi'i, he has a sheikh called Waqi'. Imam Shafi'i is going to visit his sheikh, also to complain about something. Imam Shafi'i said, he was a young man. A lady walking in the street, wind came, show her legs, Imam Shafi'i looked at them. He couldn't memorize anything after that. He tried to memorize, it's gone. He went to Waqi'. He said, Imam Waqi', my memory, my brain is not working. Things are not as used to be. Waqi' said, and Imam Shafi'i said it in a very beautiful poem. شكوت إلى وكيع سوء حظي فأنبأني بترك المعاصي وأخبرني أن علم الله نور ونور الله لا يهدى لعاصي. He said, I went and complained to وكيع about my weak of my memory. And he said to me, O Shafi'i, the key, quit committing sins, asking Allah for forgiveness, because the light, the knowledge that Allah gives is a light, and the light cannot be given to someone who commit ma'asiyah. وَنُورُ اللَّهِ لَا يُهُدَى لِعَاصِي. Immediately, the effect has seen. But that happened to true believers. Other people committing, Rasulullah ﷺ said, the munafiq and the mu'min, the difference between them. The munafiq commit a sin, big sin. He look at nothing, just like a fly come to his nose, said like that. You know? And he might come and talk about it. He says, oh my goodness, that was a party. We drank until the night, you know, the morning. Nothing. He said, how's it be like, you drink alcohol? Yeah, once in a while. Nothing, the sin is not there, it's not bothering. A believer, small sins, look like a big mountain. Jabal. He thinks that the Jabal is going to collapse on him or her. They take it serious. Therefore, a person, all of us should, in order to maintain this purification of the heart, need to check ourselves. What do we do that affect this light of the heart? Now, the other things I would like to say about jawarih, about our body parts, that we have always to remember that everything you need to purify. When the heart is pure, we would like to do what? Purify the tongue, purify the hand. I cannot be a believer, someone who is really, their heart is full of iman and pure, and go and commit, for example, a physical abuse. How can a person, their heart become pure and their hand is not? A person curses someone, calling them names. That's an indication of the heart is not pure completely. And whatever, even whatever in the heart, this tongue take away, the hands take away. Therefore, we like to have everything is in control, inshallah. Why also can purify our heart? Being in the right place, in the right with the right company. Sometimes our heart is clean, but we do what? We allow other people to put input on it, just like computers. They're telling us things, suggesting things. Whether shaitan of ins, human, or shaitan of jinn. They're very good in that. They don't see a pure heart, they don't keep it pure. You know, they would like to bring all their trash and so forth. They would like to throw things. You know, have you seen a sign? When people say no trash, no things thrown in the street and so forth, what they put the sign? No what? What? No, no, what? In today, in, when you go in the neighborhood or the lobby of a building, no what? No what? No littering. You should say in our heart, you know, put it here, say to those people, no litter, please. Not allowed. Okay? Don't tell me any backbiting, I'm not going to take it. Don't tell me anything that, you know, don't suggest anything to me, please. Don't tell me that you like to do this and that. You know, please, big sign. Can you do that? Maybe you should write it in big sign and put it here in our jacket, go to work, and say it here in the heart. This big heart, heart association, buy one of them, those things, and we say that on it, and put it here. Because that's what would happen. Sometimes you go very good, you leave your home, and you go to the wrong place. You leave the place, and you know that somebody had really thrown things in this house, and you didn't do anything about it. You feel so bad. Therefore, we need to remove ourselves from a situation when you know that something is going to corrupt our heart. Because that's what is it, a disease. It gets to us. Unless our heart has strong light, you go to the dark area and you're lighting the other people. That's the good heart. But you don't receive any kind of thing that affect us. And Rasulullah have made a beautiful example of that. He said, a good companion, like someone sell perfume. You sit next to them, they either they give you a gift of perfume, you enjoy it, or you buy from them, like someone who sells perfume, or you get nice smell. You're just sitting, you got nice smell, you know? Some people, you sit with them, you know, sometimes people go to some people's home and say, excuse me, can I charge my cell phone in your house? You know that? The telephone, cell phone is down. They're sure. You plug your cell phone and while you're having a conversation. You go, you leave the house, and the phone is what? Charged. Go to people where you go to their home and say, can I charge here? What do you charge in my heart? Plug in. Let us talk about something good. and you charge it during the visit, and you leave their hard disk is charged completely, can receive things. We need to do that kind of things. Can you visualize the things, charging things like that? We need to do most of that. The tahara of badan, of our body, it is one of the most important virtues of Islam also. And Islam has taught a lot about it, this aspect of tahara of the badan. Inshallah, after Maghrib, I will going to speak about the inner dimension of the tahara of the badan, of the body, and the connection of it with the tahara of the heart. How we can make that connection as we do it every day. Inshallah, as we learn the techniques, we can feel the difference. Every time we make wadu or make a ghusl, we inshallah will feel the purification of the heart. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum.
To continue with the topic of tahara, after I spoke with about the tahara of the heart, I'd like to address the tahara of the body and the tahara of the place and the connection between those purifications and the state of mind and our heart, the state of the heart also, the connection between them. The inner dimension, as Imam Ghazali says, of the tahara that we do every day. And perhaps as we do this exercise, maybe inshallah we'll feel better when we do this rituals after that. In order to purify ourselves during this tahara of the badan and the tahara of the makan or the place, we have to see what are the requirements, how we purify our body. If somebody accepts Islam, said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, we ask them to do what? Ghusl. Why? Why a person should do ghusl? A person might just come from a shower, clean, and he say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, I ask them to do ghusl? He say, what for? I'm not dirty. Because there's a symbolism of water in Islam. The symbolism of water, it meant to wash away the sin. To have a person as if a new baby come to world. As if he went to this all of this amount of birth, delivery. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah waliyu alladhina amanu yukhrijuhum min adh-dhulumati ila an-nur. Allah is the protector of those who believe. He can deliver them from darkness to light. That birth. Therefore, at that person receiving that light, you do what? Take that shower to differentiate, to make the 10 point, even in the physical sense of the previous life to the new life. And after that person enter Islam, all of his what? Record, bad sins mean what? Purification also of the record. Clean record. That means this ghusl. You know, if you read how the companions become Muslims, very interesting. He says, declare his Islam, he went to his home and come back. Of course, there's no towel that you buy from Kmart or from Hex or something like that. There's no towels. They come and their beard are wet, their hair is wet. They come to the masjid, wet, just fresh, you know, just accept Islam. This symbolism of it, okay, purification, you know, it is a person begin their life with having that. And there's a great effect of water, by the way, and also body and the state of mind, especially when you do it in that state of mind of purification. You know, when someone is stressed, they say, go and have hot shower. When you take the hot shower with the feeling that you're going to relieve the stress gets relieved. You can feel the water better. But when you take a shower and you're jumping and just going to the car and go, you don't feel that even you have. Therefore, the feeling of the water itself. Therefore, this ghusl, it begins. Islam, have a person to start entering Islam with that even physical purification, having in mind it is what? It is spiritual purification. The proof of that is a spiritual purification. If there is no water, a person does what? Tayammum. Therefore, a person said, I'm using the dirt to get dirty or to get purified. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told us this dirt is a symbol of purity. Okay? Man is made of what? What are we made of? What's our nature?
Clay.
What the clay made of? Dirt and water. Therefore, when you try to purify yourself, either the water or the dirt. No apple juice. You know? Nothing else. You know, no those perfume, one-man show or whatever they call them. This is old-fashioned, by the way. You don't use that perfume to clean yourself. Either the dirt or the water, the origin of it. Origin of man, of human being. Okay? And as a person also, that Islam teaches us that before standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if a person is state of janaba, they have to do what? Take a shower. Okay, tell ghusl. This is ghusl. Also, it meant a person when he stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he lift him himself from that desire. And now you completely spiritual. Because fulfilling one desire, physical desires, it is not a spiritual state. Although Rasulullah said, even that sadaqah. Okay? But it meant even before the stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have completely not thinking of it anymore. You purify yourself and have that ghusl standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As even as we come to Jum'ah, it is in Sunnah that to have this ghusl. A person might have taken a shower Thursday night and said, I just took a shower Thursday night. No, you need to have the state of mind you're going to Jum'ah, you're going to this small festival, and you would like to be in the spiritual purification. And there's a sifa makhsusa, there's a particular description of what we're doing ghusl, of course. Take the event, the incident, where Umar radiallahu anhu, he about to read the Quran. And he was very angry. He just slapped his sister, pushed her husband. Even the Muqri, the teacher, was hiding. The teacher was teaching from the anger of Umar, the shouting, the screaming. How she met him to come down? If he read the Quran in that anger and just grab it, she said what? You know what? Have wudu. Clean yourself, put some water on you. The water does what? Shh, bring the anger down. That's why Rasulullah said when you're angry, do what? Wadu, just like a fire, you need to put it off. You have wadu, you are very calm. Because you need to have the water in yourself, and the water has great effect. And Umar radiallahu anhu, he came with different state of mind. Took it, he read it, he said what? He left his home to kill Rasulullah, left his sister home, asking for the Rasulullah to accept Islam. And between the two moments, it was wudu and recitation of Quran. That's it. Did it. And he went, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. The other thing is that connection between purification of the body and the purification of the heart. There's a hadith that sometimes we forget to see the scene itself. And Rasulullah was sitting with his companions. He said, يَخْرُجُ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ هَهُنَا رَجْلٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. You know this hadith? Rasulullah said, a man of paradise will come from this side. You know the three times a man came, what was the description, do you remember? What was the description the companion said about him? The most obvious description all of them said. He came and the water was dripping from his beard from wudu. The Rasulullah said from a Jannah, to this moment, myself, I don't know the name of that companion. I don't know. I've been searching. If you let me know, please, if you find the name. And Abdullah ibn Umar, he said, I would like to see what makes this man of al-Jannah, Ahl al-Jannah. This man of wudu, coming with wudu, it was not only physical purification. This man has a very pure heart, clean heart. He said to him, I would like to spend 3 nights with you. Can I do that? He made an excuse. He said 3 nights with him. Abdullah ibn Umar stand up at night, making tahajjud, pray, this man, shifa and witr, done. Go to bed. But whenever he moved, and this by the way called yaghidat al-qalb, awakening of our heart. Our heart is awakened. Abdullah ibn Umar said, the only thing I noticed about this man, when he moved from the bed, he changed from position to another position, he mentioned Allah's name. يَذْكُرَ اللَّهِ إِذَا تَقَلَّبْ 3 days is over. Abdullah ibn Umar said, listen, I don't have any problem with anyone. I come to spend these days with you because Rasulullah ﷺ have made a statement about you. He said, you are the man of paradise. أَنْتَ مِنْ أَحْلَى الْجَنَّةِ And I don't see anything that you do extra. What do you do? He said, I don't do anything. Just accept what you see. Abdullah ibn Umar gave up. He walked away. The man called him, said, Ya Abdullah, maybe one thing I left. I have not slept any night with a grudge or hatred in my heart. Clean it up. You know, you have something called in the computer, the trash and recycle. You take the old files and you do, you get it into it. This man does that. He cleaned the system. Every night, the system is clean. Rid of all files. The heart is clean. Go to bed, just his heart just receiving the light from heaven. Therefore, the names of Allah there, because the heart is so sound. But remember, he has wudu too. Therefore, that's purification. The other thing, the connection between the tahara of the badan and the tahara of the heart is that Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he went to Isra al-Mi'raj, he said, يا بلال he called Bilal after the hadith of Isra al-Mi'raj. He said, يا بلال إني سمعت خشخشة عليك في الجنة. يا بلال, I heard your footsteps in paradise. Somebody walking in Jannah, I heard crack, crack, crack. I said, who's that? They said, this is the footstep of Bilal. Because for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything have taken place. Allah can so see, show the Prophet وسلم, what will take place. He said, يا بلال إني سمعت خشخشة عليك في الجنة. I heard your footstep in paradise. What are you doing, man? Bilal said, يا رسول الله, I don't do anything extra except every time my wudu is gone, I make new wudu. And the new wudu, I pray 2 rak'ah first. And he's saying wudu. He said, that's what you get you there. Wudu all the time in the state of wudu. Khashhashatan alayk. Can you imagine that? Bilal ibn Rabah, the man was beaten in Mecca, was spit at, and they said he's a slave, he's worthless, people of Mecca. And Rasulullah ﷺ came to him and said, I heard your footsteps in paradise. Khashhashatan alayka fil jannah. Wadu did it. Now, what can we do as we do this ghusl and do other things? That if you take a ghusl once a week for Friday, let us say that will be end of that week, we clean, we ask Allah for forgiveness for the sin that we did. And we start fresh every time that we do what? Bring the books before you take the shower and look at it that says, yeah, that really I need to clean all of that system now. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness and you start new. Every time we make wudu, Rasulullah ﷺ told us the effect of wudu. What is that? The inner dimension of wudu, we can make wudu like this. And then run, you know? And sometimes say, oh, you forget your foot. Oh, you know? And sometimes, oh, your face is still some of it. Oh, okay. You know, that kind of things. But let me start with myself, and then I ask you. Inshallah, I promise you, I'll try to concentrate on my wudu tonight and from tomorrow. I will do better, inshallah. I will ask Allah to help me. And I would like you to contemplate on this with me. Rasulullah said, every time you make wudu, your sin being cleaned from your hands, from your face, from your feet, from your hair, and so forth. How is that?
Because as you make wudu, you have to be conscious of yourself. One of the things that Islam teaches us is to be conscious of yourself, life around you, everything that should remind you of Allah. When you do wudu, let us be mindful. Imam Ghazali, rahimahullah, said something very interesting. He said that the presence of the heart in the time of wudu, it would determine what kind of salah you're going to have. It's going to have the effect on the salah itself. And that's why I'm going to, there's an alim of tabi' called Hatim al-Asam. Hatim al-Asam. Hatim al-Asam is a man that we know that he, you know, you have this khushu'. You pray behind him, you can feel the energy come from the mihrab. To all the lines. And people said, Hatim al-Asam, what do you do in your tahajjud, in your salah? He said, atawadda. I make wadu. ثم أجمع أعضائي. He collect himself. He just take a moment to reflect. What did he just do now? Purification of the body. Then he stand for salah, as we're going to talk about the khushu' on salah. And he said, he pray as if Jannah on the right hand, hell, left hand, death is coming from the back, and going forward to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, I finish my salah by in a khawf wa raja. From the fear and the hope. And I don't know after I finish it whether Allah accepted it or not. But it begins with wudu. Rasulullah said, the sin comes from our hands and from our body. Therefore, even he said, from beneath our nails. When you make wudu, let us, brother and sister, imagine this. You take your hand, you have the niyyah, the intention, and you say, I'm making this wudu, and I would like to prepare myself to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First, imagine that you're dressing up for an interview. What do you make sure? Your wife, if you were a man, says your tie is not right. This color is not matching. Your shoes not being polished. You're this and that. Make sure that, you know, that kind of thing. And you're a sister, you like to make sure your scarf or your dress and so. We make sure that before we go to seeing this human being, that we're really ready to meet. Wadu. It is a to prepare ourselves to stand before Malik al-Muluk, the king of the kings. That's what it is. And when we do that, we need to have qalb hadr. When we wash our hand, we have to remember that what did we do with our hand? What kind of act we did? And ask Allah for forgiveness. Come to the mouth. The purification of the tongue. This is symbolism here, washing the tongue, and we're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our tongue. Then as we do our nose and our face, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect our face from hellfire. يُحَرِّمْ وَجْهَنَا عَلَى النَّارِ. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have us be able to see him in the day of judgment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to have our eyes commit sins and look to things that we should not be looking at. As we wash our arms and feet and ears and stuff, we ask Allah for protections. When we do that, even as we wipe our head, most of the sin begins here, by the way, the head. You know, very strong, you know, dangerous organ, something called brain, where all the thoughts comes. That from it, as we wipe our hair, our head, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have us be mindful of him. Can we do this? Maybe after we do this wudu with that very intense feeling, maybe our prayer will be better. Maybe our mindset will be better. Maybe as we, after we say salamu alaikum and then we speak to our spouse, we'll be more smiling. Or as we reach out to someone, we'll be more cheering. As we, you know, approaching life, we'll have better attitude and relaxing. Let us do that. It reminds us of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, let us use the symbolism of water and purification of as we make this wudu to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lastly, I would like to say about this issue. I don't like to make the class long, and I promised 1 hour of this class actually, and last time I went over time. We would like very much, every time that we do this tahara of the badan, we have to remember the tahara of the heart is more important also. We cannot have wudu, but we're standing next to someone in salah, we hate them. We have grudge, we have hasad. We don't like the, we wish if their clothes or your car broke, we wish them ill things. We cannot do that. Therefore, as we do this purification of the body, always you have to be mindful of the purification of the heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also remind us that there is a place where you can have purification, like the masjid. The masjid is the right place as makan that you have purification. And that's why, brothers and sisters, I would like to suggest to myself first that let us make our homes tonight, go our home and make it masajid. Make purification of the place. Make the place is a warm and a place that reminds us of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If there's anything in the house you want to change that might not have you mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, change it. And have the purification of the homes is a priority, the place where you pray, the place where you read Quran. What I mean by this, for example, Rasulullah said, a house that Quran not being recited on it, like an abandoned home. Like a home that people trashed, people read Quran in our homes, then we purify the homes. The home will become pure. We clean the house from shayateen, from all kind of things, and we bring the remembrance of Allah in the house. In that house, that let's have an environment of love, that the spouses love each other, the children love one another. Create that environment in the homes, that purification of the home also, the place, the environment. And of course, there's a purification, physical purification of the house from the najasa also. That is, we set up a tone and attitude in the house that of purification of tahara. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the masajid should be the place where people seek purification. Allah says in Quran in Surah Tawbah, لَمَسْجِدٌ أُسِسَ عَلَى التَّقْوَى مِنْ أَوَّلِ يَوْمْ حَقَّ أَنْ تَقُومَ فِيهِ فِيهِ رِجَالًا يُحِبُّونَ يَتَطَهَّرُوا وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Said the home that, the house of the masjid that established on taqwa from the first day is the best place where you should be standing and praying, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because in it, in that house, رجال, here men and women, يُحِبُّونَ يَتَطَهَّرُوا. They love to purify themselves. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Allah loves those who purify themselves. Here, the purification of the heart and purification of the body. Allah says in Quran, and if we like to be loved, we want to be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to have the tahara of the badan and the tahara of the heart. Why? إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْتَوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ what? الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. And there's a connection between tawbah, repentance, and tahara. What tawbah does? When a person repents, what it does? Purify and clean the sins. When a person, at-ta'ibu min adh-dhanb kaman la dhanba lahu. When a person come and make tawbah, repentance, as if that what? They have not committed that sin, been wiped out, clean. Sincere repentance, clean sins. The same things about this tahara of the heart and tahara of the badan. And Allah loves those who are mutatahireen. Therefore, when we think about tahara as Muslims, every day in our badan, in our body, it should reflect also in our heart, in our mind. Okay? We cannot have dirty mind, thinking of evils and ills, and then taking a shower and have perfume. And what is that about? It might not help. Clean here. And then clean here, and as well clean our body from any najasa. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our heart and our mind and to make us mindful of Him in every way, inshallah. Any questions? Yes?
There's a question about the verse in Surah Al-Baqarah.
Absolutely. I had it here. I about to talk about the tahara of the clothes. You know, in Islam, there's a tahara of the clothes also. That we make our clothes pure. Therefore, it's supposed to be the mind, the heart, the body, and the clothes.
all of us have no najasa on it. As I said, there's a najasa. You know what the najasa? That anything that's not pure, according to Islam, supposed to be clean from our body and from our clothes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Rasulullah, وَثِيَابَكَ فَطَحِّرْ. Purify your clothes. Always purify your body, your clothes, your mind, and that's the tahara of, that Islam is asking us of.
What does tahara mean?
Purification. Purification. Yes.
Somebody, question. Yes. Is there a recommendation after the wudu? Should we wipe, like, dry it out or just leave it like this?
You can dry it out. You're not Hanafi. And if you're Hanafi, you keep it wet. But it's okay. You can dry out.
Also, reciting Quran at home, about the way and the volume that we should keep in reciting Quran.
You should not have your children doing their homework and you have the Quran very loud and said, they say, want to do homework? I said, no, you need to listen to the Quran. You don't do that. Okay? You want, you know, in Islam, we were told that this act of worshiping of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in every way, as you do your homework and other things, be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do not annoy people or do something that have them not to love the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If they're not listening, you don't read Quran. Or read Quran for yourself. Or maybe establish a tradition. Say all family members, 5 minutes recitation of Quran a day. Our home begins for that. That's nice. You know, you start that day. I said, okay, 5 minutes, no more than that. 5 minutes, 5 verse, 10 verse, whatever it takes. Stop on that. Start on that. Yes.
They use this verse like to say that, like la la yamassa wa la mutahhar, in terms of the Quran.
No. The ayah that there's an ayah in Quran. He asked a question. He said there's an ayah in Quran says that the Quran should not be touched except with the mutahharun. Of course, ulama of fiqh say mutahharun here, the pure people, mean those who are pure. It meant that a Muslim should have wudu to touch the Quran. And some others said, no, not wadu, it is only the ghusl, the janaba. When a person, they have a physical relation with their spouse, they should not touch the Quran unless they have ghusl before they do that. Of course, some ulama, like Ibn al-Qayyim, in his tafsir al-Qayyim Ibn al-Qayyim, he said, mutahharin here, it meant malaika. Because in Arabic language, there's something very interesting. إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون. Says this Quran, إنه لقرآن كريم is glory, a generous Quran. في كتاب مكنون in preserved tablets. لا يمسه إلا المطهرون. No one touches it except those who are pure. They say here إنه لقرآن كريم, holy Quran. كتاب مكنون meant اللوح المحفوظ, preserved tablets in heaven. لا يمسه اللاء هنا ليست ناهية ولكنها نافية. The لا هي, it does not say you shouldn't, but it say no one except مطهرون have touched it. Okay? والضمير يرجع إلى اللوح المحفوظ ليس للقرآن. I mean the ha, this is Arabic language, more technical. The ha here goes to the preserved tablet, it does not go to the Quran. That means this Quran in the preserved tablet, no one have touched it except the angels. Al-mutahharun hum al-malaik. And ulama, some of ulama says, if the Quran, people say no one touch Quran except a person have wudu. If somebody want to accept Islam as an Arab Christian, and he want to read the Quran, he said he make wudu. He said, I'm not a Muslim, wudu is not obligatory on me. I have to be Muslim first. I said, what did make a difference if I make wudu, I'm not believing in it. Therefore, that person can touch the Quran, read the Quran, accept Islam, the application even of the fiqh part of it for the Muslims. Okay? Therefore, there's more than one opinion on that. Inshallah, we'll talk more about it when we talk about the Quran. But for us reciting Quran, if when you make wudu and recite Quran, and this
in the state of purification, it also brings that symbolism of connecting yourself with the Quran in the state of Tahara. Of course, it's highly recommended to do it in the state of Tahara. Yeah.
The question is not for Tahara, but it's about Quran. As you just mentioned, that non-Muslims, we can give them Quran to read it. Most of the Quran these days that we see have both English translation and Arabic in it. And a lot of times you have Christian friends at work or some other places and you want to give them a copy of that. Is that okay? Or do you give them only English copy?
The Quran, I'm just giving you a scenario. Say an Arab who's Christian. He said, I would like to read your book before I accept Islam. I said, no, you cannot read it. How would I accept Islam? You know, just accept it and then read the Quran. It doesn't work. You know, therefore, you read the Quran. You know, read the Quran, then accept. See in it and accept Islam. That's okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Month of Ramadan in which the Quran was revealed. Hudan li whom? Guidance to whom? Hudan linnas, in that verse, guidance to humanity. That's humanity, have to have access to it. All humanity. Hudan linnas wa bayinati min al-huda wal furqan. Another questions? Okay, then we conclude, inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our gathering. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sin. Ask Allah to purify our heart and our mind. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those mutahhirin, and to be among those whom the Rasulullah will recognize in day of judgment. Do you know how the Rasulullah recognizes us? When he sees us, his ummah. How? With wadu. Muhajjaleena min athari al-wadu. With the mark of wadu. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us among those whom the Rasulullah recognize all of us with the wadu, inshallah. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have us go to sleep with pure heart, where there's no grudge and hatred or envy or jealousy. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us a comfort. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow his blessing and mercy upon all of us. Ameen. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah. Rabbil Alameen.